I have recorded this voiceover more times than I care to admit. I am making this video in honor of Earth Day, which is coming up on April 22nd, this Wednesday. Earth Day has been celebrated since 1970, so it is the 50th Earth Day. I would like you to also consider going to earthday.org and look into ways you can participate in Earth Day this year since we're all having to do things a little bit differently right now. In honor of Earth Day, I'd like to make some land art. I'm looking at images of land art just for inspiration. I could make a picture of an animal, of a person, a pattern. Some cool artists to look at are Andy Goldsworthy and Robert Smithson. In fact, let me go ahead and click on Robert Smithson Spiro Getty. Keep seeing a lot of this image when you search for land art. The Spiro Getty is an earthwork sculpture constructed in 1970, so the same year that Earth Day started. Smithson also documented the construction of the sculpture in a film titled Spiro Getty. I can't talk about earthworks or land art without talking about corn mazes. It's amazing how this is artwork made in a huge field. These images are viewed from above, so they're aerial view. Take a second to look at this. This is amazing. I recommend making this outside. For today's project, I collected items that were outside in my yard. I actually live in an apartment community, so I don't really have my own yard. So this is another reason why you should do this outside. If you have pets inside, something that you try to make out of a natural item, it could be poisonous to an animal if they try to eat it. And also, you could be bringing bugs into your house, even if you don't notice that there are bugs on the item. I decided to arrange these leaves like this, and I just kind of started pulling all the stuff I had. There's my cat. Those spiny little sweet gumball things from gumball trees. It started to come together, and I made a little box. It kind of looked like a planter. But then I was like, wait, it's like a face. Remember when I said land art doesn't last that long? Yeah. He's out of here. Bye-bye. Don't worry, I took a picture. Isn't that pretty cute? So this is on the back of a canvas, so I flipped it over and I decided to lay it this way. So the last one I made reminded me of a peacock. So this time I made a picture of a bird. I like how it turned out against the pink and the blues. Land art is usually pretty short-lived, and another word for that is ephemeral. Ephemeral art is the kind of art that is happening, and there are elements acting upon it. It can't really be shown in a museum because it's just going to change or deteriorate. Or it could be too big to show inside. Land art is an outside kind of exhibit experience. And Earth Day is a great opportunity to collaborate with nature, make something together. For more information about Earth Day, check out earthday.org. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you have a wonderful Earth Day.